the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This holy man fought to the death for the law of his God, and did not fear the words of the godless, for he was built on solid rock. We keep today the commemoration of the martyrdom of St. Edmund of East Anglia. He was king of a large area of Norfolk and Suffolk and bits of Lincolnshire in the 9th century, and he was martyred for his Christian faith by invading Danish armies. It's said that he was tied to a tree and shot through with arrows. So we pray for the church in Norfolk and Suffolk, for the Diocese of Bury St. Edmunds, and all parishes dedicated to God under the patronage of St. Edmund. We pray too for all Christians who suffer persecution for their faith. So to prepare ourselves to offer these sacred mysteries on this feast day, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you have revealed yourself as the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy. You have poured out on your people the Spirit of truth. Christ, have mercy. You are the Good Shepherd leading us to eternal life. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, who brought your martyr, Blessed Edmund, to overcome the torments of his passion, grant that we who celebrate the day of his triumph may remain invincible under your protection against the snares of the enemy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God for ever and ever. Amen. A reading from the book of the Apocalypse. I, John, heard the voice I had heard from heaven speaking to me again. Go, it said, and take that open scroll out of the hand of the angel standing on sea and land. I went to the angel and asked him to give me the small scroll, and he said, take it and eat it. It will turn your stomach sour, but in your mouth it will taste as sweet as honey. So I took it out of the angel's hand and swallowed it. It was as sweet as honey in my mouth, but when I had eaten it, it turned my stomach sour. Then I was told, you are to prophesy again, this time about many different nations and countries and languages and emperors. The word of the Lord. Your promise is sweet to my taste, O Lord. I rejoice to do your will, as though all riches were mine. Your will is my delight, your statutes are my counsellors. Your promise is sweet to my taste, O Lord. The law from your mouth means more to me than silver and gold. Your promise is sweeter to my taste than honey in the mouth. Your promise is sweet to my taste, O Lord. Your will is my heritage forever, the joy of my heart. I open my mouth and I sigh as I yearn for your commands. Your promise is sweet to my taste, O Lord. Alleluia, alleluia, our Saviour Christ Jesus abolished death and he has proclaimed life through the good news. Alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus went into the temple and began driving out those who were selling. According to scripture, he said, my house will be a house of prayer, but you have turned it into a robber's den. He taught in the temple every day. The chief priests and the scribes, with the support of the leading citizens, tried to do away with him, but they did not see how they could carry this out, because the people as a whole hung on his words. The Gospel of the Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands, for our good, for the praise of his name, and for the good of all his holy church. Receive, we pray, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise which we offer to your majesty in commemoration of the blessed martyr Edmund, that it may lead us to obtain pardon and confirm us in perpetual thanksgiving. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you, and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the blood of your blessed martyr Edmund, poured out by Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvellous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis the Pope, with Justin, our Archbishop, Jonathan, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ, through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours, for ever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his holy ones. Alleluia. Let us pray. We have received your heavenly gifts, rejoicing in this feast day, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that we, who in this divine banquet proclaim the death of your Son, may merit to be partakers with the holy martyrs in his resurrection and his glory, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.